Hi there, welcome back to today's tutorial guide. In today's video, I'm going to show you how we can create a wonderful masonry gallery in Divi. To be specific, I'm going to create this particular image gallery, which is in masonry layout. This is made using Divi Advanced Gallery module by Divi Flash. The image gallery can be a wonderful inclusion for your website to showcase photos. As you can see, this is a four-column gallery layout with a color overlay on hover as well as an icon plus text on it. This is also clickable, which will open the image in the Lightbox and the Lightbox itself navigational. So without further ado, let's check how we can create this. Before getting started, we need to make sure Divi theme is installed on our WordPress website and the Divi Flash plugin is installed and active. We are on our WordPress dashboard. From the navigation bar, scroll down to Divi Flash and click on it. Here from the top bar, click on modules. As you can see, all the modules Divi Flash comes with stays here. You can enable or disable any one according to your needs. Let's search the gallery in the search bar. Here it is, the gallery module. Mine is already turned on. You can turn it on if it's off. Now that we are all set, let's go to the pages and add a new one. You can add the gallery to your existing page. Let's give the page a name. Now click Use Divi Builder. This will take us to Divi Visual Builder. Here we have three options to choose from. I'm going to select Build from Scratch. Here for the row selection, I need just one. So let's choose the first one. Before moving forward to modules, let's set thing up for the section and row. Let's close the insert module pop-up for now and go back to section settings. Here in the section settings, we just need to adjust the default padding. Let's click on the design option and scroll down to spacing. Here we will set the padding 0 to all around. That's it. Let's save and close the section setting window. Now let's open the row setting by clicking on the setting icon. Here we don't need to set anything on the content tab. Let's move on to the design tab and open the sizing option. Let's set the width to 100%. We will do the same for the max width value. Then let's open the spacing option. Here we will set padding 30 pixels on the left and right. That's it. The rest of the thing will stay the way it is. Let's save and close the row setting window. Now is the time to add the module. Click on the plus gray icon in the center. This will open up the module list. In the search field, type gallery. Now insert the first module named Advanced Gallery. This is the look of our gallery module. With this module, you can create a filterable gallery, dynamic gallery, multiple column layout, grid layout, and many more. In this video, we will be creating a masonry layout. First thing first, let's add the item by clicking on the plus icon that says Add New Item. We will give it a title, let's say gallery. Then in the gallery image area, we will add all our images for the gallery. Click on the plus icon and this will take us to media. Here we will upload all our images or simply select existing images. I already have my images uploaded. Let's just select them. Please note, if you would like to show any text in the image, then you need to add the text here in the caption or description field for the images. Here we have URL option as well, from where you can set the click action for this particular image. In our case, we set the text view full screen on the caption field for all the images. Once done, then click the select button at the bottom right corner. Cool, all our images are here. You can shuffle those images the way you want by just dragging and dropping. Once you're done shuffling, click on the back icon to go back to the main module settings. Now is the time to make the gallery look more elegant and beautiful. Let's open the gallery setting first. Here we will set the image size to the original for a better quality image. If you would like to have an optimized image size, then go with large. For the number of image in the row settings, we will keep this to 4 items for desktop, but for tablet, we will set this to 3 items, and for mobile, we will set it to 2 items. It can look a bit messy, but no worries, it just happened for the window resizing. Once you save it, it will be fixed. Then for the layout mode, we will keep this to masonry. Now, for the space between, we will set this to 30 pixels. Lastly, we will turn on the lightbox. And that's it for the gallery settings. Let's move on to the hover settings. In the hover setting, the first thing we have is the overlay. Let's turn on the overlay. This will come up with some new settings for the overlay. Let's set the color. The color will be the same for the primary and secondary. You will find all the color code at the bottom right corner of your screen. Next up is the icon. Let's turn it on. Now from the icon selection option, choose plus sign. Let's search for the plus. Here it is, the first one. Now if we hover over to the image, we will see the overlay as well as the icon. Now let's set the icon size to 45 pixel and the icon reveal animation to fade it down. You can always play around with the setting here and choose the one you prefer. Up next, we will turn on the show caption option. This will show the caption by hovering over the image. As you can see, the position is top left corner. Let's change it. On our way, we can see the caption reveal animation is set to fade up, which is fine for me. Let's click on the content position drop-down and select center. Then for the image scale type, we will set this to zoom in. That's all in the hover setting. Let's hover over to the image and see an overlay color is there with icon and text. That is not a problem. We will fix this with the spacing option. Now, let's move on to the next tab, which is design. Here, under font style, we have two tabs. One is caption and another is description. As we only have a caption, let's change the style of it. For the caption font, we will select Poppins. The rest of the theme will stay as it is. We will set the text size to 14 pixel. For this particular design, we kept things simple, so we didn't apply any other style options. You can check all the features listed here. We need to adjust the spacing, so let's open it up. Here for the caption padding, we will set this 70 pixel on top and 0 pixel on bottom. That's all. Let's just save and close the module first, then save the whole thing from the bottom right corner. Lastly, let's exit the page and check our design on the front end. Everything looks perfect to me, and this is how you can create a masonry gallery in Divi. That's it on today's tutorial. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comment section what else you would like me to show a recipe for. To stay updated, feel free to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next one.